Hi everybody, it's me Kim Forrester back with another little bite-sized Thrive, helping us all to take steps to enhance our well-being from the inside out and turn 2021 into something 2020 wonderful, regardless of what's going on in the world around you. I promise that if we undertake these certain practices, if we do these certain things, we can literally enhance our well-being from the inside, from our physiological self, from our neurological self, from our psychological self, and that wellness can bubble up and help us make better choices in the external world around us as well. This week I'm talking about social connection. Social connection is absolutely vital when it comes to living a long, fulfilling, healthy, flourishing life. As I said in my last video, it doesn't mean you have to have tons of friends. Some of you are not built that way, and I understand. But it is about us all having a place where we know we belong and maintaining and reinvigorating those connections regularly. So today I wanted to talk about a little peptide hormone called oxytocin. Many of you will be aware of oxytocin. It's known as the love drug or the hug drug. Oxytocin is the hormone that is released from our brain into our bloodstream when we are bonding with somebody. So when a baby is being breastfed or held by a parent, oxytocin is released from the brains of both the child and the parent. When we are bonding with friends and family members and colleagues, that it is oxytocin that is released into our body. It helps us form deeper connections. It also helps us trust those particular people. Okay, so when we are with those people, we get filled with oxytocin and we feel like we can trust them and we feel supported by them. Today though, I wanted to touch on the dark side of oxytocin, because very few people realize that oxytocin has a dark side. And as much as it allows us to feel connected to and trusting of the people that are in our in-group, oxytocin at the same time actually makes us less trusting of people that we regard outside of our group. So it means that if you have a particular culture or a particular religion or a particular community that you feel that you belong to and they are your in-group and those are the people that sort of stimulate this sense of bonding and connection, I really want you to be wary, because it is very probable that same oxytocin that allows you to feel like you belong and are accepted within that group, it is also compelling you to feel mistrustful of others outside of that group. So mistrustful of people from other cultures, other religions, other communities. Now, I know many of you are dear, good people who are striving to, you know, see humanity as one humanity and would never consciously choose to judge somebody on their culture or their background or their religion. And I fully understand. What I want you to know though is that this is deeply embedded in your physiology. It is an unconscious and instinctive reaction. So even if you're someone who would say, I would never judge someone on their culture or their background or their religion, I fully understand. However, I want you to know that there is a part of you that is doing precisely that. Now, that doesn't make you a bad person. It makes you very, very, very human. However, it's best to be conscious of that, is of what is going on, so that you can consciously override it. Okay, so how can we work beyond this sense of mistrust and disconnect from those who are not in our in-group? How can we override this oxytocin boost that allows us to connect with the people that are in our group and makes us disconnect from people outside of our group? Well, the simplest way is to widen our in-group. So in the last 20 years, I have been a global traveler. I've been an expat and I have had the great privilege and joy of living all over the world, particularly here in Asia, throughout Asia Pacific. My family in New Zealand is very multicultural, Chinese and Samoan and Maori and Pakeha, which is New Zealand European. So I have been blessed in many ways to have the opportunity to widen what I perceive to be my in-group. over the coming days, I am going to encourage you to join me in widening our in-group even further. The way that we override that sense of mistrust and disconnect that comes from the oxytocin in our bloodstream is to increase the amount of people, the number of cultures, the number of religions, the faces, the perspectives that we regard as part of our in-group. So when you get the opportunity over the coming days, just explore beyond the boundaries of what you regard to be your normal, your cultural boundaries, your religious boundaries, your perspective. And reach out beyond that. See if there are people in your community that you can connect with just for a chat, right? Or see if there are parts of the world, cultures and religions and faiths and worldviews that you can educate yourself on to a deeper degree. By doing so, I think you'll begin to see the similarities between yourself and these other people, and they become a part of your in-group. And that means that you don't just have to consciously sort of go through life going, no, I see humanity as one whole, but you're also having support from your own body, right? Because when you truly see all people as part of your in-group, then your body is responding in exactly the same way, and that oxytocin will flow and it will tell you, you can trust this person, you can connect with this person. A bit of a ramble today, but I thought it was really, really important, particularly in this really connected world that we live in, and this vibrant and migrant world that we live in, where there are all sorts of people and faces and cultures and worldviews and perspectives around us constantly and all the time. Let's widen our in-group and let's use oxytocin to our advantage, because when we connect socially with people from all over the world and all sorts of backgrounds and all sorts of perspectives, then we can only thrive greater with that social connection. I'm Kim Forrester. Thank you so much for joining me. It's such a delight to have you here. Remember, I am offering personal consultations if you're finding yourself in a little bit of a fog and needing some clarity or direction, a little bit of cheerleading. I'm your gal. Go to kimforrester.net for more information, and I'll see you in a couple of days' time. Ta-da!